when you hear someone who's been in a situation to do something real special, a hero, right? They'll say, well, I just did what anyone else would do. And from the outside looking in, you're thinking, no, everyone would not have done what you did. Like, what you did was very special and it took something about you. So in that way, he is special. He's done things that he would look at and say, well, I just did what everyone would do. Colonel Mol, call sign Hawk, the really neat thing that he's done for the Air Force is he's seen two different wars. He fought in Vietnam, and before that he fought in Korea. He flew three airframes and over almost 400 combat sorties. One of the first fighter crossings across the Pacific, which was a big deal. And I think he recognizes that his generation and his contributions, he's very humble, but his contributions to the Air Force had an effect to bring us to where we are today and how we operate. And at times he pushed back against authority in a way that had positive effects. He was one of the first ones to say out at Nellis for red flag, let's paint the aggressor squadron airplanes. So not a big thing in and of itself, not a risky thing either. But those sorts of decisions, they kind of echo through the years in the future. So we learned about General Quesada and his air ground team. He wanted to put pilots on the ground towards the front lines to call in airstrikes. And that was important for the pilots to put the bombs on target and to direct them to where they need to go. And they started developing this doctrine. They brought it into Korea, and that's where Colonel Mol actually did this forward air control type job. And he was in tanks towards the front lines as a pilot, calling in these airstrikes. His ability to move forward and move out under those dangerous circumstances, it's inspirational to what folks are doing today. He was able to serve and to pursue his passion for flying, but he was able to do it in a way that served his country through Korea, through Vietnam, and then stateside. He was on the cutting edge of how we operate and how we fight wars. And it's what we're learning about in the books, about how our air power philosophy and doctrine developed from the early stages, through Korea, through Vietnam, through Gulf One. And those are the things that we took away from him and his contributions, I think. He was on that leading edge of what we do.